Chapter 675, Secrets of a Draco Bull. Amidst the commotion, Yuan Ke rode her Draco Bull and instantly disappeared towards the horizon. That one. At this time, the dragon princess didn't have time to trouble Li Kai as the alchemist standing next to her shouted and picked a bull. The princess shouted out a command and brought a group of experts to chase the target. Meanwhile, Jian Wushuang also marked her prey. She slightly shifted her figure and immediately went for one of the bulls. It was clear that she was also highly skilled in the Tao of Alchemy. She was stronger than the majority of the people here. The moment she soared towards it, this bull immediately pounced forward. However, she immediately flipped it over. The bull knew that it had met a frightening opponent, so it decided to flee to a different direction. Jian Wushuang roared and gave chase immediately at an alarming speed. Suddenly, figures fell down one after another. The rapid steps of the Draco bulls were accompanied by a melody of screams. Li Kai's gaze glossed over each of the Draco bulls that left the water as fast lightning. Of course, he was not looking for sulfur but something else entirely. Eventually, he set his gaze on a particular bull and gradually walked towards it. It was at this time that a group descended from the sky and instantly blocked his path. They were the Golden Leopard Prince's faction. "We also want this Draco bull, so step aside," the prince said as he blocked Li Kai's path. Meanwhile, that Draco bull had escaped far away in the blink of an eye. Li Kai narrowed his eyes and gazed towards the prince only to be met with a snort from him along with a cold response. "Don't make this hard for yourself. If you want to get the immortal sulfur, just hand over that young king medicine root. If not, then you won't be able to catch that bull." However, before he could finish his sentence, a shadow flashed forward and, amidst his confusion, Li Kai had him gripped by the neck and held in the air. "How presumptuous." The experts who accompanied the prince were shocked and instantly rushed forward to protect their master. Clank. But at this moment, Li Kai's body became a giant lock. In just a split second, a bright flame and gusts of wind appeared, preventing these attacking experts from getting closer to Li Kai. Then, red chains with the color of flames pierced through all their chests, incinerating them to death. Their miserable wails caused all listeners to shudder. Poof. Plumes of green smoke arose. All the experts that were pierced by the red chains were immediately burned to a crisp without even leaving ashes behind. Under the nine sunlocking heaven law, these experts couldn't withstand the fire and were killed instantly. There were many cultivators who still hadn't left the water outlet. After seeing this murderous scene, many of them felt a chill. You, dare to do this? The prince didn't expect to run into a steel wall. At this time, he was pale from fear and soiled his pants. He raised his voice and shouted, I am a follower of young noble Yi King Cheng. If you dare to touch a hair of mine, the young noble will absolutely not. Clack. Before he could finish, Li Kai had already crushed his skull. The prince's eyes remained wide open. Even at the time of his death, he didn't know why his monstrous backing didn't deter Li Kai. Yi King Cheng, I don't know him, but so what? If he dares to stop me, then he'll be killed without mercy. Li Kai nonchalantly threw the prince's skull to the side and wiped his hands. The cultivators here couldn't help but shiver after seeing Li Kai's leisurely state after murdering the prince's group of people. They all knew that this seemingly inconspicuous human junior was a ferocious man. If it was anyone else, then they would definitely show some consideration for Yi King Cheng. Li Kai didn't even bat an eye before turning around to instantly chase after the escaping Draco bull. At this time, who would dare to compete for this bull against Li Kai? Unless they were tired of living, they would turn a blind eye to it. Tai Yi, who was hiding underground, eventually showed his head after Li Kai had left. He patted his chest while still dazed and murmured, "So vicious. Luckily, I didn't offend this demon king or the result would have been unsightly as well." Having said that, his eyes rolled and cheerfully laughed while saying, "Time to go, gotta pick up the spoils." Then, he disappeared into a cave. Li Kai flew in the sky with extreme speed and caught up to the Draco bull from earlier in a very short time. Although this bull wanted to escape, Li Kai locked onto it with his divine intent, so no matter how it tried to escape, it couldn't elude him. Li Kai instantly appeared in front of this bull and blocked his path. This bull instantly halted, creating a huge ditch in the ground. At this point, the bull gazed at Li Kai while breathing out hot air. A vicious beast like a Draco bull would not easily back down. Boom, boom, boom. This bull gathered all of its energy then immediately rushed towards Li Kai's direction at a horrifying speed like an unleashed divine arrow, which was made especially apparent by the pair of horns on its head with their flashing lights. When sprinting in such a manner, it seemed as if this pair of horns could pierce through all things. However, Li Kai was unperturbed against this oncoming attack. He stomped down with one foot and pounced forward at an unbelievable speed as well. Boom. Li Kai and the bull slammed into each other. This explosion horrified all those who heard it. Such a collision was enough to collapse one mountain after another. The bull was blown flying far away due to the impact, and it crashed into a large forest. Meanwhile, Li Kai was still standing there, motionless, like an unshakable mountain or hidden rocks under a river, always withstanding the tides of the river. Boom. The bull climbed up as its four hooves stomped onto the ground fiercely, causing the earth to shake. A Draco bull was indeed amazing. It suffered zero injuries after such a crash. Boom, boom, boom. The bull was not convinced at all. It, once again, mustered more momentum and used its strongest form to come charging. Li Kai only smiled and leisurely said after seeing the bull wanting to test itself again, "If you want to try me, then I'll show you." With that, he stomped his foot down twice this time and once again pounced forward. Bam. The result was not unexpected. The bull was blown away by Li Kai again. This time, blood sprayed out. Although the bull's entire body was covered in dragon scales on top of having great power, it was far too lacking compared to Li Kai's hell-suppressing and soaring immortal physiques. Boom, boom, boom. The unyielding bull, once again, charged towards Li Kai, but it was blown away time and time again with no chance to compete. Eventually, the bull was covered in blood and lied on the ground, gasping for air. It was no longer able to stand up. Li Kai smiled and said, "This is more like it. Even if you have 10 lives, it still wouldn't be enough if I really wanted to kill you." At this time, he stood in front of the bull and used his hand to tap on its forehead again and again. Banging sounds reverberated from the bull's head like the echoing of a valley. Buzz. Eventually, a faint sound appeared. The bull's head finally had a reaction after Li Kai's continuous tapping. Pop. Strings of crimson light came out from this bull's forehead. The streaks of light continuously increased until they were as vast as an ocean. Among this vast ocean, a huge mountain appeared. Bah. This huge mountain flew out from the crimson light inside the bull's forehead. Moo. This bull was shocked by this sudden change. Even it didn't know that there was such a thing in its head. After the huge mountain flew out from its head, the bull ignored all else and ran away despite its injuries, instantly disappearing without a trace. Li Kai didn't chase after it since his goal was not the bull, but the thing ahead. His eyes were fixated on the mountain. This mountain before him was emitting a huge amount of crimson light as if it was a sea of blood. However, this monstrous landmass was not a mountain. It was formed from many blood era stones stacked on top of each other. These blood era stones were without flaw and were absolutely of top quality. Even characters of a god monarch level might not be able to enjoy such amazing blood era stones. These stones were covering a ray of light. After a pealing sound emerged, the stones opened up, creating a dazzling brilliance. In the blink of an eye, the light rushed out from the stones. Inside was a dragon, a golden dragon. Roar. This golden dragon roared towards Li Kai. It was so powerful that it was as if a true dragon had descended to the mortal realm. The aura of an extremely tyrannical divine beast filled the sky. Even heavenly kings would tremble before this horrifying atmosphere. Hold on, old golden bull, it's me. Li Kai shouted with a thunderous voice while spewing out mantras. With sonorous sounds, these mantras seeped into the head of the golden dragon. The initially attacking dragon halted after hearing Li Kai's words and changed its mind. At this time, Li Kai's forehead opened and a brand flew out. This brand immediately struck the golden dragon's body and disappeared inside. There was a sudden change to the golden dragon once Li Kai's brand entered its body. All of the bright lights disappeared. The moment the golden dragon landed on the ground, it turned into a water buffalo. It was a sturdy-looking buffalo without any special characteristics outside of being stronger in appearance compared to other buffaloes.